This is Basic Electronics Lab. I'm your course coordinator. And these are the practicals we are going to discuss. Maybe we are doing some more practicals than them. But right now, this is the main list. So first practical, first three practicals, four practicals are rather very important. Why these are practicals are very important? Because these are the particular equipments we are going to use in Basic Electronics Lab. Number one is multimeter. You are going to use multimeter and how you are going to use that. That's we are going to learn that. Second thing is DC multiple power supply. How we are going to use that. Then next is cathode ray oscilloscope. Then function generator. So these are the equipments you are going to use when you are actually performing your practicals. So out of them, I think in your schools, you might have used multimeter and power supply, but you have not used cathode ray oscilloscope and function generator. Once the study of these devices, equipments is over, you will switch on to main course practicals. And that includes your first practical, that is operating characteristics of PN junction diode. Then we will discuss about Zener diode and how we can use Zener diode as voltage regulator. And after that, we will have input-output waveforms for half-wave rectifier using diode, then full-wave rectifier using diode. And then we will be working on PN diode as clipper. Next practical is about clamper. And last two practicals are common emitter configuration of transistor in both the configurations, common emitter and common base. So these are the practicals and they are quite useful. You will enjoy working on them. And the major portion of this course is focusing on your PN diode and transistor. So we will be discussing about them. Other practicals are also there, but right now I will be focusing on these practicals. Once we are comfortable with these things, we will move towards other practicals. So this is the first device on your screen. That is your multimeter. You are going to use this extensively. So I will be discussing about this later on in coming classes. I will be discuss using some video so that you get a live demonstration of this. Okay. So here you can see this is your display. This is the LCD display. Here you will find out auto and DC. That means right now this is giving you DC voltage. So if no probes are connected, it is supposed to give this value 000 millivolts. That means it is a calibrated. If you are getting any value here without applying any probes here, what you are getting, some false values. So you are supposed to calibrate that. Now I will be discussing one by one the various components. This is your display, and display is what the quantity you are going to measure. So what are the various quantities or electrical quantities you can measure with the help of multimeter? So here you can measure voltage. So voltage can be measured for DC as well as AC. This multimeter is capable of giving you temperature. What is the temperature inside your lab? This multimeter can also give you the value of capacitance you are using in your circuit. It gives the value of resistance. Then you can also measure frequency. You can check connectivity also. Suppose you want to check whether a particular track is connected or not. So you will connect those two points. And if beep is there, that means connectivity is there. If beep is not there, you know that connectivity is not there. Then next is HFE. That means you will check out what is the beta value for a transistor. So this will be discussed once we will study transistor. Then here for last four points, we have your current measurement for milliampere, 40 milliampere, 400 milliampere and 10 ampere. So the maximum rating of current that can be measured using multimeter is 10 amperes. So these are the various points which is very important, and the various quantities which we can measure using multimeters are voltage, temperature, capacitance, resistance, frequency, and also we can check connectivity. You can measure HFE value of a transistor. You can measure current. Also, you can check whether a particular transistor is NPN or PNP and it is working or not. So that can be checked with the help of this socket. So socket, you can find out emitter base collector emitter. Emitter base collector emitter. So here you insert the pins of your device. And once you insert the pins of the device, you will select this onto HFE. This is a rotationary knob. So you will get the value of HFE. So if you are getting value of HFE and you have inserted your transistor in a particular socket, you will get value of HFE. So this will gives you an idea whether a device is working properly or not. Now coming towards these buttons. So this is your frequency percentage. Right now it is of no use for you people, but if we use this in lab, I will tell you how to use this particular button. Then range, you want to measure particular quantity in millivolts, volts, kilovolts or something like that, or maybe ohms, kilo ohms or mega ohms, then this range can be changed. If there is some error, that can be checked with the help of delta. And data, you want to store some data here, you can use that. But this is of no use as far as basic electronics is concerned. Then next thing, select. You can select the mode in which you are actually operating your device. Here, on some places, you will find out two options. So you can select which option to select. Either you want to measure DC or AC, or second thing is you want to measure connectivity, or you want to check whether diode is forward wise or not. So this can be selected with the help of this particular button. Suppose you want to measure the capacitance directly. So these are the terminals where you can insert the pins of the capacitor. You can directly get the value of the capacitor. Now about these four pins, ports rather, we can say this is common port. And as you already know that when you want to measure the voltage, it is to be done in a parallel manner. And if you want to measure the current, your multimeter is to be connected in series. So when you want to measure multimeter, the red probe should be here, black probe is there. So you can measure the current. You have to connect this probe in series in between. So I will let you the circuit, know about the circuit in near future when you actually use the multimeter. And if you want to measure the voltage, resistance or something related to frequency, you insert the probe here. Now, if you want to measure a current of very high amplitude of magnitude, 10 ampere, then you can use this particular port. So this is all about the multimeter. If you have any doubt in this, you can ask me. That's
so. Could you explain ACL again?
AC?
SEL, topmost right corner.
Select. Select button is there. You want to select whether you want to measure AC or DC, or you want to use connectivity or this. So that can be known from your this particular select button. So you press the select button, the particular thing will be displayed here. Okay.
Sir, in HFE also. The way.
Yes, pardon?
Sir, in HFE also near the knob, near the connectivity.
HFE?
Yes, sir.
HFE is related to transistor. Basically, it's forward and the current rate. So it's about your transistor. Okay.
So the range button, yes, is it used to calculate the range of resistivity and conductivity also?
Range?
Say yes, of semiconductors, insulators or conductor.
Range is basically to increase the range.
Suppose not to calculate the range.
No. It's okay. Basically, suppose where you are measuring DC, so it is in millivolt. So it can be microvolt, it can be volt and something like that. You can increase the range.
Sir, is there any device that we use to calculate the range of conductors or insulators or semiconductors?
No, it's not that range. It's range is range of measurement. Range of measurement. Okay. Suppose you want to measure a 0.1 volt. Okay. So if you have this being set at 1000 volt, so this will not be able to measure that. what you can do, you can select the range of 1 volt. So in 1 volt, 0.1 volt can be easily displayed. But if you change the range, it gives you plenty of columns. So that's why range is being used. So to change the range. So I will show you that when we make a video regarding to that. Okay.
So then COM also.
This is COM port, common port. Basically, this multimeter is having two leads. One black lead, another one is red lead. So black lead is common. So suppose you want to measure a current. Then what you have to do is, one terminal is connected to your resistance, other is connected to the circuit. Because you can connect device only in series. Yes or no?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So then this is for current. And if you want to measure voltage, then you will take that lead out, place that in this particular port, and you can measure the voltage. Voltage can be measured in or parallel. So common is there. It is being used in both the cases. So common, we can say it's basically negative or ground for your particular signal.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, any other questions regarding multimeter?
Sir, what is the function of MA, small m and capital A? Sir, it's
milliampere. 4 milliampere, 40 milliampere, 400 milliampere. Because we are dealing with electronic components, we are dealing with currents in milliamperes and microamperes.
So sir, what is the triangle button, sir, given after the range button?
Triangle is some sort of error. If error is there, you can correct that. Some variation, you want to calibrate your device.
Yes. Suppose, sir, milliampere used to find small current, currents.
Yeah, in devices, transistors, we have very small current, 0.1 milliampere or maybe 10 microampere. So how you can measure that? That is being measured when you have pointed your knob to this particular point.
Sir, the button below the range and the border and the button near the connectivity frequency are the same.
Which one? This button?
Sir, this frequency button near the connectivity and the button below the range are the same, have the same function?
We normally don't use multimeter for measurement frequency, but sometimes you know that something is there with frequency, then we can use it. Although we are not using this in lab, the buttons we are most commonly using in lab are VCs, this voltage, capacitance, resistance, connectivity, HFE, and this. We are not using this button in lab. We are not using this button in lab. This. And that. We are using range reflector. We are using this right in lab. Okay? And we are also not going for 10 ampere because we are working on a very small current value.
Sir, what is the function of HFE?
Who's asking? Miren Kukla? Or Hriday Kulwar?
Sir Hriday.
Okay.
Sir, I got disconnected from the class, sir, due to network issue.
Okay. HFE?
Yes, Hello? Sir.
What is the function of HFE? HFE is basically a forward current gain. Forward emitter current gain of transistor. We will discuss when we discuss about transistor. Okay.
So my question, was HZ percent and percent HZ were the same.
Yeah, they are same.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
When you are dealing with frequency, you have to turn this knob to this particular point. This knob is actually rotating. So you want
yes,
to
sir.
And so on. So if it is collected, then only this button will work. Otherwise, the button will not work.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Any other question?
No, sir.
Okay. So next device which we will be talking about is function generator. Okay. So right now it's quite a difficult thing to discuss function generator in using a single picture. But I will try my best to give you some idea. Later on, we will make a video regarding that. Yeah, what you can do is you can search YouTube for function generator. There you can plenty of information. In the meanwhile, I will also create the video for your function generator. Okay, so let's discuss this function generator.
The screen is not visible, sir.
Not visible?
The screen, yes, sir.
might be network problem is there.
Sir, audio is coming clear, sir, but the screen is not.
Actually, what you can do, scroll the participation list. There you will find out Anil Bhardwaj twice.
Yes, sir, I have found out, sir. I have found out, but I am clicking to that, but it's not opening.
Then you are using 2G network?
Yes, sir.
Then it might be the problem. I am creating the video, so you can see video. Okay.
Okay. Excuse me, sir. Sir, will this be available on your YouTube channel?
Today only.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Once the class is over, I will create it and upload it on you.
Okay. Sir, thank you. Yes.
So that you can.
सर आपके YouTube चैनल पे सर काफी सारी वीडियोस है हमको सारी देखनी है या फिर उनमें से कुछ ही देखनी है
बेसिक इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स प्लेलिस्ट ऑफ
यस सर दैट्स ऑल ओके सर थैंक यू सर
ओके शुड आई स्टार्ट
यस सर नाउ इट्स
यस सर
ओके नाउ द नेक्स्ट इक्विपमेंट व्हिच वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इज फंक्शन जनरेटर So here you can see so many buttons are there, but right now I will focus on the buttons which you are going to use. Most of the buttons you are not going to use in this particular course, but the basic buttons you are going to use, just note down the function of these buttons so that you don't find any difficulty while using them. Okay. So the first button is power button. So you press it down. Your system will be on. I will make a video for
sir, can you also point to these buttons, please?
This button. This is power button. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Then what kind of mode you are operating for your device? And what is function generator? Function generator is basically a equipment which is being extensively used in electronics to generate waveforms. Waveforms, you know, the sinusoidal waveform, your square waveform, and your DC waveform, triangular waveform, and so many other waveforms are there. So those can be generated with the help of function generator. So why we need those functions? Because we are actually using them when we get a particular functionality of the device to be tested. Suppose you want to check out that if I'm giving a sinusoidal input to the circuit, what is the output? So from where you get the sinusoidal input? This function generator is going to provide you various sorts of input patterns and from one frequency to another frequency. The range is from 1 hertz to 20 megahertz. Please note it down. The range of function generator is from 1 hertz to 20 megahertz. Okay. And depending upon model to model, we are having several models in our lab. So we can have different things being implemented. Now next is, this is your power button. Once this is turned on, second, you have to select the mode. What kind of output you are going to use? Suppose you want to use triangular, sinusoidal, sawtooth. So that will be there. Okay. Then sometimes what happens? Your device is not in the range. So you can select the range. Suppose you want to use kilohertz signal and your device is in hertz or in megahertz. So you can change the range just by pressing these two buttons. You want to increase the range. You want to decrease the range. Just press these buttons. And if you want to change the frequency, this is a rotatory knob. You rotate this knob and you will get your frequency being changed. Okay. Now, sometimes you want to increase the amplitude of the signal. Using this knob, you can increase the amplitude of the signal. And this is the port from where you are actually getting the output. So this, I will give you a demonstration, video demonstration of function generator in the near future. Right now, for you people, this much is sufficient that function generator is a device which is used to give you signals which can be used as inputs to to test various electronic components and equipments. That's all. And from here, you can select the mode. And this is from where you can select the frequency. And this is the port from where you will get the output. So how you're getting the output, there is a particular probes for that. I will show you in the video in the near future. So if you have any doubt regarding function generator, you can ask me. The detailed things will be available on the video. That will be created in the lab.
So can you repeat the definition of function generator?
Function generator is a device that is being used to generate waveforms that can be used to test the functionality of electronic devices. Okay. Okay, it's fine. Hello.
What did you say after that can be used to
test the functionality of the equipments?
So what does speed and width knobs do?
Sweep. These are basically rotatory buttons. You want to change the level of the signal, but right now it's not possible. It can be shown only in the video. So sometimes we will have a live class with function generator here, then only I can show you. Otherwise it's not possible for me to show you. Okay, so I'm creating video for that. Okay, in the meanwhile, what you can do, you can watch some video on function generator on YouTube and create some curiosity regarding that. And once this thing is over, we will have video very soon, maybe next 2-3 days, we will have video regarding function generator. Okay, so that in that I will give you complete demonstration of multimeter, function generator, and so on. Okay, so if you have any other question,
sir, what is TTL, the socket, the what is
TTL? Basically transistor logic. As I already told you that this is a very versatile device, can be used in most of the applications in electronics. But right now in basic electronics, we don't have any concern with TTL. We only focus with output. And output can be increased or decreased with this minus 20 dB, minus 20 dB. That means whatever your output is, you can reduce minus 20 dB if you press one. If you press another, you will reduce it by further minus 20 dB. So you want to reduce, you can be convenient with that thing. Okay. So most of the buttons functions cannot be shown to you right now without having a live demonstration. So maybe in next 2-3 days, I will be creating the video. And from there, you can get the exact idea how things are actually working. Okay, any doubt?
Sir, we would be getting notes regarding it. Book? Sir, we would be getting notes of this lecture, or you will just post the video?
Yeah, video, as it is video. It's interaction video, so I will post this video. Okay.
Okay, sir, continue, sir.
Okay. This is another equipment you are extensively going to use in your class or lab. That is just, excuse me. Okay, so this is your cathode ray oscilloscope. So what is its purpose? I hope you might have seen such thing in hospitals when you visit the hospitals, but this is not the machine, only displays having some similarity with that machine. So here you will find out this 40 megahertz oscilloscope. That means this oscilloscope is capable of measuring frequency up to 40 megahertz. Okay. 40 megahertz means frequency is measured in hertz. 40 megahertz means 40 into 10 to the power 6 hertz. Okay. So what is the function of this? As I already told you, you are applying some input onto your electronic device and you are getting some output from your electronic device. So input you are getting from function generator. So how you will know what kind of input you are actually applying to your device? So what you have to do is you have to apply that input to this channel. It is having two channels, one channel and channel two. Then on this you will get a display that this is the kind of input you are actually getting. Similarly, you will connect output of your device to this, and here you will get the output corresponding to your input. So this is just basically a display sort of thing, that what is the actual display you are getting, what input you are actually applying and what output you are actually getting from your system, that you are actually going to display on CRO. That is the thing. Now it is having plenty of buttons. So you will find it very interesting how you are actually going to use it. But right now, again, it's a demo class, but without video, it's not possible for me to show you. What we can do, I will just telling you the various buttons which are going to be used. And later on, when I make the video, then you will get the clear idea what these buttons are for. So I will start from top. So here you will find out power button. This button is meant to turn on or turn off your CRO. Okay. Then X position. That means if you want to move your signal in X position, then this knob can be used. This is normally off. And here, this is also in this particular position. So this is the default position. You are not going to change it, because in basic electronics, you don't need any R&D sort of thing. Okay. Then if you want to increase the time period, then you can change it. Okay. So then your, if you want to change the way of your amplitude, you can change it. This is for Y position. Suppose your signal is like this. Okay. So what you can do, actually my marker is not working. Color is not working. It's not working here. So your Y position can be changed using this. And what you are actually measuring, you're measuring DC or AC, that can be selected using this. And also you are using channel number one or channel two, that can be used using this button. And these are the points from where you are actually giving input. Here you are applying input to the CRO. So two channels are there. Okay. So what is the purpose of this particular equipment? Just to display the signal and its properties. What kind of signal you are actually applying and what kind of signal you are actually getting from the device. So that information you can obtain from cathode ray oscilloscope. Again, I repeat, the detailed description and clarity to this will be available once we have a video for this particular device. Okay. So if you have any questions, you can ask.
So does it have a limited range of 40 megahertz, or it is a smaller version of it and it has a longer, has
actually,
a longer
range of these days, when you talk about your mobile phone and all, they are working in gigahertz range. So for that, we need different sort of equipments and their cost is quite high. But in lab, we don't have that much frequency variation. So it's fine with 40 megahertz. Okay.
So meaning it has a higher range.
Yeah, yeah. In gigahertz also. Otherwise, how you will measure? Otherwise, how will you measure higher range?
Okay.
So basically, it is connected to the function generator and it is used to draw the graph, whether it is a sinusoidal graph or a triangular graph or a square graph.
Yeah, actually, it's a sort of, what I can say,
It is an output device. Input is the function.
Display device. It's a display device.
Yes.
It will display. It helps you that what input you're actually applying to the device and what output you're getting from the device. So
yes,
this gives you very good idea. And on this, you can measure frequency. You can measure amplitude of an unknown signal also.
So okay. the bluish graph shows the whether the graph, the sinusoidal graph and the square and the triangular graphs.
Yeah, any graph is there, and using these boxes you can actually calculate that what is the frequency of the signal, what is the amplitude of the signal. So that I will give you the idea when we actually conduct the lab on this using some video.
You have to control the properties of the output also.
Pardon?
We can control the properties of output also in by using.
No, we cannot control. We can change the vision. I will tell you the simple example. Suppose your height is in centimeter. Your height is 181 centimeter. I want to know. Give me in feet. What happens? In centimeters, it's 180. In meters, it becomes 1.8. In feet, it becomes 6 feet. So what does it mean? Your height changed? No. The way you look using some different units have changed it. Otherwise, it is same. Height remains same. Similarly, a signal remains same if you change the scale. So instead of using millisecond, I am measuring in microsecond. So what happens? Your signal will be actually expanding. The signal remains same. Your height remains same. Height is 181 centimeter. In feet, it is 6 feet. In meters, it is 1.8 meter. And in kilometer, how many kilometers is your height? We ask like that? No.
0.01.
Is kilometer is a bigger scale. Kilometer is
a bigger scale.
So similarly, what happens when you will find out that your signal is smaller, then what you can do? You will increase the range. You will increase the range so that it is comfortable. So I will show you that when I will make the video.
Just so we can see the output in different units by this device.
The output remains same, but you can see in millivolts, you can see in volts, you can see in microvolts, whatever maybe. But amplitude remains same. It is not going to change. Only the scale is going to change. We are actually changing the scale. These two knobs are going to change the scale of the magnitude, and this is going to change the scale of the time. Time is in.
So, how changing the scale will help us?
For better understanding of the signal.
So, the below two knob shows the voltage because it is written voltage and millivolt.
Yeah, this is for amplitude. If you want to increase the amplitude, you can use these two knobs. And if you want to alter the, not I can say alter, you're actually changing the scale, how you're measuring the time, then it will be working in a different manner. Okay?
So basically this device is used for knowing the graph of the frequency or what? So generally this CRO device is used for...
Shape of the waveform. CRO is, you know the shape of the waveform. Then on CRO, you can know about frequency. What suppose you are getting unknown signal, then you are interested in measuring the frequency. You can use CRO to measure the frequency. Also, you can measure the amplitude of the signal. So these are the, also you can compare the phase difference between two signals on CRO. If you are having two signals and I ask you, how you can measure the phase difference between these two signals. So then CRO can be used to measure the phase difference also. But that's a different thing. But if you are interested, I can show you all that also, that how you can measure the phase difference on CRO of a signal. If two signals are there and they are just having a phase difference and shape is same, frequency is same, amplitude is same, then CRO can tell you how you can actually measure the phase difference. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Any other question?
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, what is TVSCR SCP button?
This is related to television. Okay. Because these CROs are very old one. When we have this CRO, we are having CRT, cathode ray tube. So here you can see horizontal. This is horizontal, this is vertical. So if you want to do some changes here, you can do using that. But I say, the basic electron, not to bother much about that. Okay?
So this device is also used by space agencies.
Any other doubt?
Sir, TVSC and TRIG are set off as default.
Yeah, we are not going to use that. This is a trick, basically. Sometimes you need that. But
they are shut off as, they are put off as default.
Yeah, this is the default thing.
Sir, why the name cathode ray is used? Does this have anything to do with cathode rays?
Yeah, this is only the front panel of the CRO. It's a very big thing, actually. You can see on the Google. It is having bulk. It is a very bulky equipment. I will show you.
So this device works with the help of electron bombard.
You have asked the question. I will let you know. This is the screen you are having. This is a glass coating. And below that, we are having a phosphor screen. What happens? Below that, we are having a cathode ray tube. So when you are applying a signal from here, that is applied to the cathode ray assembly. So that signal gives you an electron bombardment on this screen. So when you bombard something on phosphorus, illuminance is created. So you will find out the screen will be illuminated at certain places. So this is how you get the output on this particular screen. But that can be only shown on video. So today in the class, so most of the students are saying that they are interested in attending the class. So that's why, otherwise, before the next lab, we will have video being uploaded and you can see the actual thing on CROs. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Sir, this device is... So, device sir, is there electrons related to which has electrons are used in running this device?
In the back of this, you are having a cathode assembly. In that, your beam, electron beam is generated. That hits on the phosphor screen and illuminance is created. Okay. So, you can see on YouTube also. Okay, any other doubt?
No, sir.